What's going on, everybody? It's Joe Gentle with Trend Trading Academy. I'm here to help you trade and get paid. Guys, it's episode two. In episode one, we had Robert, and we were talking about not being a loser. Nobody wants to be a loser. We talked about how culture kind of molds us into, you know, what we think, what we, you know, feel, and essentially how we gauge results. And so we don't want to be losers by standards, but we wanted to go in and really focus on our mindset, our skill set, and our trading psychology. But in this video, we're going to talk about some really serious stuff here. Number one, probabilities and how that works, superstitions and how we bring those into the market, and even, I mean, deep stuff. Are we getting PTSD from trading? Are we experiencing symptoms of PTSD from trading? That's crazy. Watch and see. If this video brings you value, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. If you want to become a student, go to trendtrading.academy. Join with us today and let's see how we can take you and help you to go to the next level in your trading journey. For now, let's get to the content. Have faith in your mind, faith in your brain, invest in yourself, transform in your time. Have faith in your mind, faith in your brain, invest in yourself, transform in your time. Taught everybody is that if you're going to be a good forex trader, you gotta be decisive. You know once you know you have a trade, you got to take it, you know. Can you talk about that for a second? Like, what goes into the mindset and the trading psychology of somebody not really wanting to pull the trigger or press the button when it counts?
Yeah, that's a great point, Joe. This is one of the reasons why finding a mentor right away when you're ready to get going is so important. They can help you. Like, basically what's happening there, Joe, is a new trader basically ends up traumatizing themselves before they even find help, because they want to test things them on their own, right? They're trying new things. They're trying to figure out how to make money. They see that their friend, cousin, brother, whatever, made $20,000 in Forex, and they try, okay, well, if they can do it, because he's an idiot, I can too. You know, they don't understand that guy could have just gotten lucky, you know, or he's been through a process and so he knows how to trade, even if he is an idiot, you know. So a lot of people think that you have to be super smart to trade. No. You just need to develop some skills and create some habits that sometimes are contrary to how we grew up, okay? But again, going back to the point that you made, traders traumatize themselves, right? They blow their account. They lost a large chunk of their account. And now when they go to trade, now they're hesitant, right? And so here's the setup. The setup is perfect. It's exactly what they were looking for. And they can't pull the trigger because they remember the last trade. And so here's another thing about trading psychology, helping people understand, again, that if this is a market based on probabilities, then the last trade has nothing to do with this one. Sure. It has nothing to do. It's like flipping the coin, right? People think that, you know, what are the odds that you flipped a coin 10 times and it came up heads 10 times that the 11th one is going to be tails? Well, people think that there's a high probability just because this one has been going off on heads 10 times in a row. No, it's the same probabilities. It's the same probability. So when your edge is present, you have to take it. But the new trader, having been traumatized, has a hard time pulling the trigger and then becomes hesitant and doesn't quite know, you know. The experienced trader knows that if they make a mistake, they can correct the mistake. Sure. It's no big deal. You know, if they lose on this trade, no big deal. They know they're gonna win on the next one. But the new trader, not having had the experience and being comfortable with themselves in the trade and having experienced the trauma from before, will become hesitant. So again, right. I think it's super important for everybody out there who is considering trading for real to find themselves a mentor right away. Way before they end up with PTSD. You know, people don't realize that they don't, you know, again, I'm from psychology. I know that Anything that is traumatic, anything that causes you a loss, anything that causes you emotional pain can create PTSD. And so basically now you are hesitant to take action when you know you should because of the prior experience. It is best for a new trader to hook up with a good mentor that can help them walk through and navigate those, especially those first few steps, you know, to get them going in the right direction before they end up with these issues that that actually can affect them for a long, long time.
Sure. No, that's a good point. And you brought up a really good point that, you know, because I have seen so many times in my years of trading where, you know, maybe somebody loses a few trades in a row, or maybe they win a few trades in a row, or whatever it looks like. And it's kind of like a pitcher in baseball who's maybe had been in a slump and, you know, he's had a couple of bad outings and now he's due for a good game, you know, and that's superstition. You know, right. we bring that type of a mentality into trading, you know, where we step to the plate and maybe we haven't hit real well in a while. So now we feel like we're due for one. And, you know, that's not the way we ought to bring it in. I love what you said that, you know, if you flip the coin 10 times about the 11th one, you know, that probability resets after every flip.
Every time.
Every single time. It's 50-50 no matter what.
Every time.
And every time. That's a great point. I'm really glad that you talked about that because I do feel like so many times people come in and after, you know, maybe building some consistency, that challenges their consistency because now they feel like, was this true consistency or was I just on a lucky streak? Or, you know, the truth is that what really is going on is that we build our consistency. We start to build some continuity in our trading. We start to find a rhythm in what we're doing. And, but our mindset and our psychology doesn't allow that growth to take place in us and to become a part of our trading because, well, you know, we just got lucky or, well, we're due for one, or, you know, we bring that superstitious type of, mentality, almost a gambler's mentality into it. When the truth is it's hard work. Your hard work is paying off, or maybe a bad habit is causing you to continue to lose. It's not that you've just been unlucky. Maybe there's something small that you're doing that you're not seeing that's causing those losses. You know, that's a good point. Thank you for talking about that, Robert.
That's perfect what you just said, because that's exactly it. You could be just a small tweak away from right. being consistently profitable. You got everything else down. You have your technique down. You know your setup. You know what you're looking at. And it just could just be just a small tweak. Or just simply you just ran into a bad streak. You know, I just, you were talking and I remembered Derek Jeter when he turned 40, the opening of the season, he went through a slump, right? And everybody was trying to tell him, okay, do this, do that, and change this, change that. And so he did to try to please the coaches and whatever, trying to do different things. And then all of a sudden he realized, okay, for 20 years, I've been doing my swing the same way. And for 20 years, I've been batting 320. You know, I'm on my way to the Hall of Fame. I'm going back to what I always used to do. By the end of the season, his stats were exactly the same as they have been for the last 20 years. He was just in a bad streak. Sometimes we run into losers in a row, you know, 3, 4, 5 losers in a row. And we didn't do anything wrong. But the new trader or the unconfident, the one that's not confident, doesn't have the confidence in them, what they're doing, may think, oh, there's something wrong with them, you know? Yeah. And so anyway, a good coach can help them line up and say, no, let's see what it is. Let's do that little tweak, not the big massive tweak you think you need to do, just a little tweak, and you'll find yourself being consistent again.
And it's those little things that cause big impact, you know?
Yeah,
little,
man.
Something small, like, you know, maybe just getting in a little too early. And a lot of times getting in early or getting in late is not due to maybe chart recognition, but mindset. Or maybe hanging on a little too long or getting out a little, you know, like those things sometimes can be mindset and not chart recognition.
That's correct.
You know? So I think that's very powerful. It's a great point to understand is that, you know, a small correction can bring major results in your trading.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about one last thing, because we have some other questions we're going to talk about, some other topics here that we're going to, tackle here while we have Robert. But excuse me, when it comes to your trading psychology, many times we kind of mislabel things. Let me say it that way. I kind of alluded to it a moment ago. Maybe we attribute an early entry to chart recognition. We just marked that space up a little wrong or whatever. But the possibility is that maybe it had something to do with mindset. So when we talk about that, Robert, and how do we know, speaking of trading psychology, how do we know that we have the right trading psychology? How do we know that we're in the right mindset? How do we put ourselves in a position, if you would, to be in the right mindset and in the right trading psychology while we tackle the chart? So how do we know we're in the right mindset?
That's a great concept right there that you just brought up. There is a video in the community, in our academy, that I made, I think about 4 months ago, how to protect yourself from yourself. Mm. And so the idea is understanding and watching your habits and what is it that you do on a consistent basis that is tripping you up. I was that guy, Joe, who would go in early every single time. Sure. Now, I've watched myself do it 15 times in a row. Why am I still doing it? You know, I mean, it doesn't make any sense, right? I mean, eventually I had the analysis correctly. It was going to sell, sure, but it didn't sell for another 3 hours. In the meantime, I had to endure 20, 25 pip drawdown, sure, and I'm stressed out, you know? And then finally it comes back my way doing exactly what the analysis said, but I was too early,
sure,
right? And so what I've learned, again, protecting yourself from yourself, using your own psychology, knowing that about yourself, your impulsivity, so you have the analysis right, but you're just going in too early. You know, that's something that I did quite a lot. So what I learned to do for myself, and it may help others, is just play games. I created some hedging against myself, protecting myself against myself by simply not coming to the chart as early as I used to. Mm. You know, I would come to the chart at midnight and create the setup for the team to send it out. But then I would sit there and I start seeing things that are not really there. They're not ready yet. You know, it's just too early. You know, we trade the London. And so there is a pre-London move that usually happens, and then London happens and the volume comes in, right?
Sure.
So I would be going in at 12, 12:30, 1 o'clock before the actual move started, which is always usually a fake out, you know, and then the move really happened around 1:30, 2 or 2:30. That's the pre-London before London opens. That's when it will reveal its hand. And so what I've learned to do, again, after watching myself do that, and this is why we tell people to journal, right? Because if they're journaling, eventually you're going to catch, oh, wow, look at that. I'm doing this all the time. And the setup is working correctly. I'm the one that's going in too early. So again, knowing enough about yourself to know how to prevent yourself from getting in trouble. In my case, I learned, don't come to the market so early. Just wait. Just come around 1:30 to 2 o'clock, sure, when it really starts moving. Okay. And then sit in your hands and wait, because the market is going to reveal itself to you. It's going to show you its hand here in just a minute. So again, to wrap it up, or to go and finish the point that you were making about things that we do repetitively that sometimes hurt us, is you need to record those things and you need to become aware of the habits that you have that are tripping you up. If you do so, you will find, especially if you've been at this for a little while, if you've been at this for about 6 months, you probably already know how to set up your chart. You probably already know what it looks like when it rejects from resistance, when it bounces from support. You already know those things, technically speaking. And so perhaps it's just noticing what is the habit about you that you are doing that is tripping you up before the setup is ready for you.
Right.
And if you do that long enough, you're going to see, oh, wow, with a huge, larger consistency, it does come my way. but it doesn't come my way for another couple hours or whatever. And so you learn, again, the things that you need to do, whether it's meditate, you know, pray, take time to listen to a little bit of music before, don't be on the computer so early, you know, go get on your Peloton, which is what I do now, right? I got my Peloton, I ride that Peloton, and it takes some of the edge off of me before I trade. Again, learning how it is that you operate when trading and how to, again, defend against your old habits to create the new ones.
That's awesome. That's good, good, good advice, man. Good advice.
Thank you, bud.
And you talked about how, you know, journaling. So I feel a little plug coming on.
That's right. You got a great one.
I feel a little plug coming on.
That's right.
But, you know, guys, if you don't have the journal already, you got to go to tradinggetpaid.com, get your Trade and Get Paid trading journal, and I'm walking you through 52 weeks of trading. Listen, everything he just talked about is exactly what I provided to you in that trading journal. 52 weeks of mapped out journaling of every trade you take, cheat sheets, everything I give you. Including my own trade plan that you can template and use to build your own trade plan. A lot of awesome stuff in there. So go get your journal, tradinggetpaid.com. There's that plug. So, all right, guys. So, man, was that awesome or what? What a great insight to trading psychology. What great understanding that we were able to see today. Thank you, Robert, for being on today. And I can't wait. Next week, we're going to come back with an even deeper topic. We're going to really make kind of bring this where the rubber meets the road. We are going to be releasing videos of real stuff that people are going to actually be able to apply, you know, not just fluff, not just some little video that, you know, doesn't really matter. We're giving you some game, okay? The next thing we're going to talk about is... Tune in next week.